Hi guys, welcome back to our channel. This is Six and today I magbibigay ako ng ideas especially sa mga beginners on how to build a home recording studio or bedroom recording studio setup at kung ano ang mga gear and equipment na mga kailangan. Ano nga ba ang mga kailangan upang makabuo tayo ng isang recording studio sa bahay or sa ating bedroom mismo? I'll give you the list of the equipment and gear na mga kailangan nyo upang makomplete ang inyong recording studio setup. This is not in particular order, but first you need a condenser microphone. So I have here samples of condenser microphones. We have the BM800. Which is common sa mga nag-home recording. And I also have here the Audio-Technica AT2020. And meron din tayong isa dito na 240 Pro. For microphones, ito yung ginagamit natin syempre for our vocals and some instruments. So basically, ito ang magka-capture ng audio source na papunta sa ating recording software. Second one is pop filter. So other terms for this is pop shield or pop screen. So this one serves to reduce or eliminate the popping sound. So kailangan natin to guys, especially pag magre-record tayo ng vocals para maiwasan ang mga unwanted na popping sounds. If you don't have a pop filter, so alternative naman natin is ang microphone foam. So, same lang sila ng function, actually, ng pop filter. Third on the list is MIDI keyboard. So, pasensya na, ang daming alikabok ng aking MIDI keyboard. This device is very powerful. May isa akong video kung saan in-explain ko ano ang function nito and how to set up the MIDI keyboard. So, you better watch that video. But, to sum it up, ito ay pwede mo magamit for making instrumentals or beats or loops within your DAW or digital audio workstation. Fourth on my list is studio headphones or studio reference headphones. Magkaiba po sila ng function ng ordinary na headset guys. Meron din akong video explaining how this one works. So basically, these studio headphones ay nagbibigay siya ng flat frequency, which is designed for mixing and mastering your vocals. The next one at ang panglima is studio monitors. So you can use this alternately with the studio headphones in mixing and mastering. Kasi masakit din naman sa tenga kung always na lang headphones yung gamit mo. Also, studio monitors give flat frequency, same as the studio headphones. Ang pang-anim na kailangan nyo guys is audio interface. So, I have here the Behringer UMC22 na audio interface. This one is considered as the heart of the recording kasi dito mo i-plug yung microphone. Pwede din dito yung studio headphones at saka yung studio monitors. Ito yung nagko-convert ng signal from your input devices going to your DAW. And last but definitely not least is laptop. So, kailangan nyo ng laptop or desktop para ma-process yung mga recording nyo. Kasi we need a digital audio workstation or DAW para doon ma-process yung mixing and mastering ng yung mga vocals and different tracks like mga instruments. Actually, marami na ngayong laptop guys na mura at pwede siya for music production. And regarding sa mga DAW, marami ding free online na hindi nyo kailangang bayaran. Kailangan nyo lang siyang aralin ng mabuti. So, for PC, merong Audacity, Banlab, ano pa ba? Marami yan guys, Reaper, for Mac naman merong GarageBand, Logic Pro, Pro Tools. There are actually different types of DAW or digital audio workstation. You just need to explore and experiment kung saan kayo magiging compatible in terms sa device nyo or sa skills nyo din. So yun lang actually yung mga kailangan nyo guys. Those are 7 na nasa aking personal list. Kung meron kayo nung mga binanggit ko na equipment and gear, you're good to go for a home recording studio setup or bedroom recording studio. Meron pa actually mga optional sa list guys, and nakadepende siya sa budget niyo of course. And kung meron din kayo dito mga optional na ibibigay ko, is mas mapaganda pa yung setup niyo. So you can also have a microphone stand. Another one is the isolation shield or isolation booth. You can also add acoustic foam, especially kung ang room nyo is masyadong ma-echo, kasi nakaka-affect siya sa recording nyo. Kung mag-bounce yung vocals nyo from the wall then going back to the microphone. Kaya importante yung booth or shield or acoustic foam to provide a good, you know, quality sa inyong recording. Also, aside sa laptop, pwede rin kayo mag-invest ng second monitor or extended monitor. Advisable is 24 inches and above na monitor size. Para mas malaki, tingnan yung screen ng yung DAW. So for beginners, kung may additional questions kayo, please don't hesitate to put your questions sa comment section down below. Sa mga pro naman at mga advanced, kung may mga suggestions kayo, kung ano pa ang pwedeng idagdag sa list, then pwede nyo rin ilagay sa ating comment section para makita naman ang ating mga beginners or mga newbies. So I hope you learned something from this video guys. And kung nagustuhan nyo, please don't forget to leave a thumbs up. And please consider subscribing by clicking the button down below. And pakihit na din yung notification bell para naman magiging updated ka sa aking mga future videos. Thank you so much for watching. Bye for now.